just a little bit differently today. So if you can just give your attention to the screen here and
office assistants. An office assistant collects folders from a classroom teacher and brings them to the office. The folders usually have notes for the office or ice packs for the nurse. Also, the folders could have money for raffles, lunch money, attendance, and lunch count from the classroom. Morning announcements. This job is one of the most popular. If you have this job, you say the announcements every morning with Mrs. Miller, and the whole school can see you on the school meet. We say the Pledge of Allegiance, the weather, announce any birthdays, and say any messages from Mrs. Miller. On Monday morning, we announce the morning message and any athletes. On Tuesday, classes challenge other classes by asking them questions like how many planets are in the solar system. Wednesday are word days. We share a new word for students to learn about. On Thursdays, the first graders share a poem on the Google Meet. And Fridays, third graders share a joke. Bus cycles. This job usually takes place in rain or shine and in the cold weather too. We hold signs in front of the buses to show what number bus it is. The younger students look for these signs to make sure they get on the right bus at the end of the day. Recycling program. We collect plastic from recycling bins, weigh the bags, and find the total. Plastic is donated to the trash program. If we collect the most plastic, we may win a recycled bench from trash. The benches in our lobby were made from recycled plastic. To participate in the trash program, take a look around your home and see if you can find some of these things to bring in for the contest. Clean and dry grocery bags, bread bags, case over wrap, dry cleaning bags, newspaper bags, ice packs, wood pallet bags, Ziploc and other reclosable bags. Produce bags, bubble wrap, salt bags, cereal bags, pet treat bags, and of course any other soft plastic. Collecting laundry in the morning is an important one. Once we collect all the dirty laundry, we will leave them for the high school students to take them first. The laundry is for cleaning the desks in the classroom. Store. The school store is located in the cafeteria and is open once a month. Students who have this job help sell items during lunch. It's fun to help the younger students decide what to buy too. We sell pencils, pencils, and bookmarks. Parents can purchase gift certificates for the students for $1 per certificate. This job takes place twice a day. We put the flag up in the morning in front of Coxsackie Elementary and take it down at the end of the day. Miss Irene teaches us how to operate the flagpole and how to fold the flag properly for school.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Librarian.
You're librarian.
Who may be here tonight?
Hello.
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 the fourth grade community service program is run by the three fourth grade teachers and Mrs. Zancelli. So that's Mrs. Whitford, Mrs. Roush, and Mrs. Hazelton.
Are you looking forward to next year?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. In middle school?
I'm just here to give a brief update. Facilities is not an exhaustive list. It's just some, not even really highlights, just things I chose to share with you for the next few minutes. Corner lot. The corner lot down here on Sunset Station Road, as you can see, has been completed. And now the grass is going in pretty good. The guys are mowing it. It looks really, really good. There's a gate that still has to be installed. You can see a chain link fence going across right now, or chain link, chain going across, and putting a gate in over the summer. Fiber at CE Pavilion, behind us over here, it was a change order slash extra in the phase two capital project, and the vendor priced it out, and it was astronomical, and I reached out to a local vendor, and he came in, and it was costing us $0 to run fiber out to Pavilion to do whatever Mr. Miller wants to do out there with it, plug and play, all kinds of stuff. So it's it was a good phone call to make. High school cafeteria floor was completed last summer. I don't know if you all been in here. It was taken down to bare tile, and a new type of finish was put on. It hasn't been holding up that great, so I met with the representative. He came down, and he's agreed that something is wrong. So this summer, he's coming down July 10th with his partner. We're going to buff it down a little bit, if you will. Put down another clear coat, put down more flakes. There's a bunch of multi-different colors in there. And then reseal it at no cost to the district. So it's another good thing that's going on. There's a four-way camera that we're going to put out behind the backside of the press box at the stadium field, which will enable us to pick up the tennis courts, the whole entire view, all six courts. We can pick up the five-bay and more towards the long jump area and also back parts of the parking lot, which will help us out tremendously since we do have a slight little bit of vandalism on the tennis court next year, so this will help with that. High school, middle school gym floors. This summer, the first week of July, we have 2 weeks to complete it. Put an RFP out. They'll be screening down both floors, which are in need of it, and then repainting, getting rid of a few logos, and painting the end lines and foul lines around it, and putting down new wax. And it's going to look terrific when that's done. Summer painting every year. I've gone through to all the building principals and myself have looked at the rooms that are in desperate need of paint and try to prioritize that. So right now, it's all done in-house by approved painters that you guys approved. We have about 4 to 5 rooms and there will probably be a few after that as well. There's also carpet to tile in here. We try to pick 2 or 3 rooms to get rid of the old dilapidated carpet in some of these classrooms. So we put out Actually, tomorrow is when the bids are due for that, so we've got two rooms that we're doing this year. Outdoors, EJA is getting an additional playground within the playground this summer. It's for preschool, right? Preschool. That will be going on, and there's a structure that they're also putting up in the back for shade. And then we're also going to be addressing the fenced-in area. In long term, it's going to be a capital project, but right now there's a garden and there's a fenced-in area. We're going to take half of that, strip it out, bring in some of the piece stone from the playground for all the pre-K kids, to keep them corralled in there, if you will, and keep an eye on them. So that's going to be happening this summer.
Can I just ask Mike, playground, the new playground, will be, it won't have its own fence within the fence.
It's going to be within there, yes.
Okay.
And it'll have a border. If you ever go through Athens and you have that very multi-colored playground right by the ball field, it's Miracle Recreation, it's the same company. There's a blue border, it's a much better blue border, because that one you can see split, plus it's barely 20-some years old. And we're going to tuck it into the northwest corner, so it will have its own little border area, yes. Our grounds overall, we hired a seasonal grounds worker who's working out tremendously. He's a workhorse. He's also pulling out from our current groundskeeper that we have, and together the two are making a big difference. It is nonstop. You could go from one side all to the other, turn around, and keep coming back. And I say they're doing a great job keeping up. The grounds do look good. Phase two capital project, what's left? We're at the very end. Praise God. We've got the switch here in. We're waiting to get the lights up in front of the high school. There was a mishap. There was wrong connectors that were ordered, if you will. So they are in the process of getting them back, put the lights up out. Just miscellaneous connections they have to make. And they're pretty much done. We're going to put some bowers around the new transformer that we purchased, that's the school rooms now. Clean up, punch out list, and then phase two will be complete.
That's the piece we've been waiting for?
Yes, long awaited, yes. They stripped out the old transformer room. These instruments that were in there were from 1953, and they were impressive. It was impressive. And a lot of copper. So that's all stripped out. We had everything was new, and it's working out great. The capital outlay project is another summer project where we'll be replacing these two doors behind you. And they'll have electronic latches, as well as the back corner gym door, the one that's tucked in the corner, man door, has a really tall aluminum storefront on top. Those two will be replaced this summer. And then right behind that, right now everything is going from SED all through Scott Wolf, CS Archer, submittals for approval. Make sure they have everything right. And then right behind that, once all the paperwork clears and the dust settles like that, EJA will be right behind that one. There's no date set for that one yet, but they'll have the same two doors there. And the one in the gym replaced as well.
And there's a swipe room that you're planning?
For these doors here, yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Both buildings.
Both buildings, yes, for the two double doors, not the gym doors, but these two double doors, yeah.
If we get a date for these, could you just let me know for summer rec purposes?
Sure. Yeah, we're still trying to get a hard date on that and figure out.
It doesn't have to be, whatever. Yeah.
We did, as you noticed, there were some issues with the one door, where I'm going to put a new panic hardware on that to secure that, and it's working out much better.
So you said for the two double doors, so the door that is the same cafeteria door like this at EJA, but not the gym door, the gym hallway door.
Correct, the single door
but
that's
still,
inside the gym.
We're still working on that.
Door,
yeah.
I think you're referring to door 3, the one we looked at earlier today. Yes. Mm-hmm. It's the mobile seat of door 37 out here.
Yeah, that's also another in the mix. Yeah. Yes, it is. Yep, the same as door 37 here as well. Good question. To wrap it up, custodians and cleaners, they're They're doing a good job.
When they, they're the, I believe, the only unit that works 12 months a year, right?
After the clerical.
Oh. Besides the admin and clerical, they do a good job. It's really a thankless job. You never really see the night crew. You see the guys during the day. Both tasks are totally different. Spring break they're here, summer break they're here, winter breaks they're here. And are they perfect? No, but no other units perfect. They do good, and they do good. They have Saturday events. They always, I have to go through a list every Saturday. There's an event. They take turns doing that. So that is it for the facilities update report. If you have any comments or questions, that I can answer. Best pizza dough recipe. Anyone have one you can share with me?
Don't you have? You have that. Right?
I'm working on it. Yeah. I'm working on it.
Well, thank you and your crew. You did hear that you saved a bunch of money with the fiber going out to the pavilion and other things that you're all doing, and we do appreciate the work. Sometimes we do see some of the folks here in the evening, and they're very friendly and helpful to us, and appreciate
if
that.
If not, you let me know.
No, it's very nice. So send our thanks to them. I know you run into a recognizing the grounds folks because of how well the stadium,
the whole grounds
especially, and the whole campus are taken care of. So appreciate that.
Yeah. You don't mind. Could be part of higher purposes. He's here, he knows. We had one of the unit members save a life. Sharing that. There was Smart, was down at Dutchess County Fairgrounds last weekend.
Running back car show a couple weeks back.
A couple weeks back, and somebody went into cardiac arrest, and he used the CPR he learned here and saved a life. So we're recognizing on our closing ceremony as well. Not one, but like.
Yes. All right. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Spencer, your updates.
Exit survey results. Packets there. And I'm going to go through each one there. I wasn't a huge turnout of responses, though, historically speaking. In that, you can see the votes who did respond. Some one said yes to the budget there. Just go around and see the reasons why. The folks voted yes, otherwise keep current programs, keep the quality of education, keep the things we have here, enhance what we can in that regard. The folks who said no, the taxes were too high, it was the highest of my people, but it was the highest response there. You all know where you want to take it. On the village taxes, the town taxes, the county, the state taxes. So, oftentimes, show their opinions through their refusal, which is fine for them. So, it keeps going. This is some demographic ones here. Just add, what they'd like to see, just long term planning, the board, the finance committee, budget planning committee. We also stay next year. We're also thinking long term out, to sustain things we have here. I know they got cut off on this slide. Just ensuring all students are life ready. It was 81% there. It's the top one. So
So it gives us a little bit of information, and you know, certainly something we'll be looking at in the next several months. As I said in the past, it's always good to plan out programming and priorities and needs before the budget process starts. So this is really a conversation about academics before we have a visiting college assess. Next capital project, again, you get to get feedback from the public. I'm here. You can see health, safety, and security was a top choice, as was air conditioning classrooms. We talked about that for the night. So this committee, we'll leave that at the moment. Cost. And just some other demographics as we go forward here. So a big chunk of our voters are have kids in school. Grandparents. This just some general comments. You know, somebody was thinking of sending their kid here. What would you? What would you say? Why? I see staff, of course, was mentioned many times. Right from the sub. So they have diverse course offerings, teachers care. I like the kind of private school education as a public school setting. Any topics you'd like to learn more about, either through newsletters, public forums, or parent community council, for their just learn more about basic reading and writing, access to mental health supports. We're going to back on what projects our students complete, how the district is changing, except for parent etiquette and social media. So, so a little bit of snapshot, not a lot of depth there, but you know, some things to think about and for our information. Next topic I just wanted to briefly talk about is, as you know, last or 2 weeks ago, day 16, we had Bill Baggett, who was presented to the board, presented to all our teachers and community assistants on how education is changing, but in how AI and technology, if anything, is more about why we need teachers even more. You know, there's oftentimes people say, oh, tech's going to take the place of teachers, and that's nonsense. So we had a really good presentation and some discussion both there about artificial intelligence, ChatGPT is the core of that, and how teachers can use that to lessen their workload, and then also conversations about how do we teach our kids how to ethically and appropriately use this technology that they all have access to for that. So it was a good conversation, and afterwards it was a Q&A. People who stay, and a good group of people who stay out to ask some questions, things like that. If it's, you know, 15 years ago, it was like, well, you can just Google it, right? You can just Google it. Now, AI takes that a step further, type something in, and in 15 seconds, you have a lot more detailed answer or example. Or, you know, in the teacher's case, you go on, I use this example that you did when I saw Bill present a couple months ago. Just chatting about it. So I went on to one of the sites and I just typed in create a 8th grade math lesson. I copied and pasted one of the standards for 8th grade math. And in 15 seconds, I had a lesson plan that's probably proud of. So, as a math lesson. So, I assume it was about social studies for that. So, that's, you know, some things. Yeah, I wouldn't speak it. You know, that's one example. You know, teachers could use that. And of course, with students, you know, how do they use that? And then as teachers, help them learn how to modify and adjust and create from the base of what was created from AI. So it is an interesting phenomenon that's going on. I think there was a survey, I saw some survey about this. You know, who are you afraid of AI? It's a national survey. More than half the country is afraid. They're afraid it's going to somehow hurt humanity, or they think it's going to take their job away. So, you know, certainly, obviously, we can do evil things with it as well. As far as a short example of the NBA, somebody can like, take a couple pictures of you, and then they can throw you right into the game. That's not like a video, you can be right in the action there, you Mr. Dine will have, of course, Sam Duncan, you know, over the Mets.
Oh, but not yet.
For that. So that was, you know, that would be fun and interesting. But of course, it would be bad if they then take a world leader and have them say something and publish that out, and people would just, that's the president of this country, and he said this before they realized it's fake. The whole deep fake thing that's going to happen at some point. So we have to teach our kids, too, how to be smart consumers of information. Unfortunately, it'll be harder and harder to know what is real, but at least on the real screen. Next topic, I just wanted to briefly talk to the board about this, to kind of give a preview. I'll look more into this in June meetings. The Sheriff's Department wants to have the SROs in all the schools become wear body cams for things. So, so there's been some draft MOAs. I think there's one. You can get it tomorrow morning. So it was a draft MOA. It kind of gives you a little idea about it and how it works. And it's still being worked out between the different varying school attorneys and sheriff's office attorney. I do know they agreed that we will have the right to, if we ever want them to take them off, you know, like to say no more, we'll have that right. So once that gets marked, finalized, if you will, at least a draft. I will also have the time to have one of our attorneys also to speak to it as well. Any questions on that? Well, if you have, just send them my way so we get a list going here. So they're doing great. Sheriff's Office very well. June events, and these aren't all of them. Just some of the highlights here. Just May 31st for the June, but next week is the high school concert, 7 o'clock, June 1st. We put the baccalaureate.
Baccalaureate.
Baccalaureate. Yeah. Oh, there you are. Okay, yeah. That's all exciting. Then you're organizing. Giving the kids for that. The showcase of student success is June 5th at 5:30, 6:30 at the elementary. 7:30 in middle school and high school. So we're going to have all the kids here and parents, food, prizes. Sorry, I didn't want to take away your board, regular board meeting on the 15th. Staff appreciation lunch will be noon in middle school and high school on June 22nd. And then June 23rd is our closing assembly at 8. We're on our retirees. I have some closing remarks. Like I mentioned, board, I asked one of the person who's the president of NYSA if she'd like to come out and speak to our group. She said yes. So we just picked her presence somehow to be here on that day. That's cool. Graduation, June 23rd.
How long is the closing ceremony thing? What did you say? Assembly? Sorry.
It over 10 minutes. We won't start right now.
That's not helpful. All right.
We'll be done by 10.
Okay.
Expect the
meeting to 8-ish to 10-ish?
Okay. I'd say 8-ish.
Okay.
Who's people?
Well, I like to be there when it starts, so that's why I like to, so I'm not late for it. That's right.
But 8-ish. 8 to 8:15 will be mingling.
Okay. I can
get it all ready. I mentioned Ed, so again, we will recognize him again at the end of the year here at the ceremony. I think that might be the as well. It was phenomenal, lightning proud of what he did. That sucks. It's a cool thing. It worked, We talked about that. Remember the incident of the Buffalo Bills player. Let's get everybody to and see if we can. We'll figure out how to do it. So, kudos to all that. Lord, especially with the guys. That's just a good guy. So. Summer meeting, so July. So what is the board's, on the Wednesday the 5th or Thursday the 6th? August, traditionally the third Thursday, but the August 17th, but again, all of a sudden, 17th, we're going to be set to be somewhere. I have an August 2nd.
Updates
left
in the morning.
Restaurants or stores around in the area, just to encourage the kids to come back
questions about the shoe? It's going to be great. We're very excited. The next thing that I want to talk about is the middle school improvement plan. So, one piece of very exciting information. We were able to, this year, we dropped our non-participation rate down to 3%. That is down from around 20% last year. The importance with that is that, if you remember, which I talked about much earlier in the year, one of the reasons that we did not get off the list this year was because you're only allowed a 5% non-participation rate, and that could be students who are taking alternate assessments, students who have opted out, students who were absent from the whole test. Regardless of the reason, you're only permitted to have 5% of the students in a particular cohort not take the test. Anything above that 5% counts against you, so it counts like that student received a 1, regardless of what the student's abilities could have been if they actually took the test.
The test being the assessments?
The state assessments, yes, the 3-3 math. So by getting that non-participation rate down underneath that 5%, that means that the student scores will be reflected correctly in our analysis of our growth, because that's the area that we're looking at in terms of moving off our comprehensive school improvement status. So that's very exciting, which means kids who took it will get scores. I'm very confident they will get scores better than a 1. And we should hopefully, we were almost off the list. Our participation rate kept us on for one more year. But again, as I've mentioned, with every not so great thing can sometimes come a great thing, which is that we continue to get the money and $250,000 is a nice amount of money to receive. But we are hopeful that this will be the last year that we are on the list. So with that said, for this year again, we will have to do the school improvement plan. They tweaked the process a little bit more because they like to do it to us every year. So we have to go through a few more hoops with it. We are going to have a table at the showcase to try and get more parents involved on the committee. They have a little bit more of a prescribed program where they want you to be working everybody through 10 meetings. So it's more of a time commitment than it has been in the past. In the past, it was just we met as many times as we needed to make the plan. This has a more set organization. You can take, they look at it as 10-hour-long meetings. You can take them and switch them together and say have a half day, and you can count that. If you work for 3 hours, you can count that as 2 meetings. But they want to kind of make the process a little bit more prescribed than they had in the past. So we're going to have a table at the showcase to try to get some more parents to be involved. I know that last year we had some board members, and we'd love to have as many of you as want to come on and help make the plan. Again, this year, that would be terrific. We have to have it done by July 15th, so there'll be a fairly tight turnaround, but we'll start very rapidly after we get the people hopefully signing up on June 7th. So it's open to anybody who wants to participate in that. Prior to the 5th, we are going to start working on, we'll still be doing the focus groups that we have done in the past with students. So we'll work on organizing that, but we'll try to get to have parents participate in helping the table groups and things. Any questions on the
meeting? When do the meetings start?
Well, when we get a few more people on the 5th, we're going to try and start doing the following week to get everybody in the schools. So we'll have a few dates up. Right now, Frey is working to get any teachers who are interested in volunteering. So then from then, we'll find out what afternoons or evenings could possibly work. And hopefully, when people are signed up on the 5th, they'll know who's the first.
Say thank you everybody for coming out to vote. We had 65% vote yes, which is well above our 10-year average there. So again, thank you to everybody that came out and voted. In addition to the budget being passed, we also did gain the capital reserve that we were seeking. And I'll get into that a little bit. I'm sorry, I want to get to the reserves presentation. If
you guys are over there, I'm going to skip over the reserves presentation, because I've got a slew of contracts to just get through and just discuss with you. The tennis court RFP did come back. We did only have the one company bid on it, despite us reaching out to three people. The bid came in right around where we thought it was going to. The information is right on the board docs for you. The summer food service program, I posted the public notice that is already on our website, and then I did post the anticipated flyer that is going to be going out as well. This is my first go-around with Canva, so I think it looks pretty sweet. But if you have any feedback, I'm willing to listen, I suppose. I've got two SRO contracts for you for next year, for the 23-24 school year. One for the Athens PD, the other for Greene County Sheriffs. If you have any questions about those, we can certainly have that discussion. And then, as we had the shred truck come in this past week and shred a bunch of just prehistoric documents here in the district that don't worry, we went through records management and made sure we could actually shred them. I came across this What is a Treasurer's Report document that was in the bottom of the filing cabinet. Just thought it would be helpful for you guys to review, see if you have any interest in it. I know that stuff makes me excited. I'm so sure you guys love Treasurer's Reports as much as I do, but that's what it is. So if you have any questions on that, by all means, please reach out and let me know. The Board of Ed one-on-ones I've been having with you all, I'm about two-thirds of the way through it. Looking forward to wrapping those up, and then I will get the promised holistic document out to everybody just so we can all see where we all stand with each question and responses. A slew of contracts came in the past few days here, so I just wanted to quickly tell you what exactly they are for. They are below for your approval later on in today's agenda. We've got the Needham Risk Management contract, we have to do that annually. The two IT contracts, one is for our network engineer, the other one is for our help desk services from the National Group. Top form contracts, that is for the education of our coaches. That offers CPR classes for our coaches, but also offers our coaches to go up and get the required coaching certifications that they need. That has to be done at it's within 3 years. Kurt will probably talk about that at the June meeting when he gives you the winter spring sports update.
Is it just for coaches, Brian?
Yes.
Just coaches, okay.
Yes. So we have a separate contract for with Top Form for them to come in and do like the grant CPR training.
Somewhere I was seeing the past child abuse reporting. Was that in this? I thought it was a list of things that this group did.
That I'd have to look. I'm not familiar with this.
Okay. Needham does do the.
Top form is the coaching class.
So people can. So do we use that with Needham?
Yeah. Yep. So, no. Well, yes, with Needham. That's what we do at the beginning of the year. The top form one is what the. So I'm a brand new person, I want to coach soccer, right? So we let you coach soccer, but within 3 years we need to complete the level one, the level two, the level three courses through top form. And because we have this contract, our coaches can go and get that instead of the coaches going and paying for that on their own, and then just hopefully they get it.
So the year provides the mental health training that we need by September 15th?
Yep. Center for Disability is an annual contract for our special education students, and labor relations, this is a revenue generating contract that we have with SCODAC. That is the whole, we employ our labor relations negotiating team with Robert, and then our attorney with that, Kevin, and then we generate money from other schools so that it's basically a wash for us. This year we're actually in the 23-24. We're actually making money on employing them, which is great. And then finally, there's a health and welfare services contract for the Rensselaer City School District because we have two students that attend the Don Stewart School that, again, we have to show you guys. Okay, so annually, I am required to present to you guys the reserve status of where we stand. This has been shared with you, so if I'm going too quickly, just tell me to slow down.
So in this, I just am aiming to describe the purpose of the reserve, the establishment of it, give you all the information that you need relating to it, how it was established, when it expires, how much money can be in it, how we can withdraw money from it, etc. So this is an overview of the balances of our multiple different reserves. The only one that is not listed on here because it was just voted on is the new capital reserve. The new capital reserve has a probable life of 10 years and a maximum of $5 million. 2014 reserve is the one all the way to the right there. Forward, we're going to call that the 2014 reserve. The new one we'll call the 2023 reserve, just so we can differentiate the two of them. The tax tertiary reserve, the number is still 500,000 and change in there. Obviously, just in recent weeks, we have agreed to pay the settlement amount for that. The check is not cleared yet, so technically it's still on our books. The check amount was $232,750. The differential then would be the amount left in the tax tertiary. We do have a couple of potential tax tertiaries coming our way. We have two from a local housing unit and then a third one from CERTA. So with that in mind, I've put together a recommendation to pass along to our auditors as justification for maintaining money in the tax tertiary reserve. Traditionally speaking, you're not supposed to have money in a tax tertiary reserve unless you can substantiate it. They don't basically want schools using it as a bank account. So there's our workers' comp reserve. We've got $193,000 in change in there. This June, we will pay $100,000 to the self-funded workers' comp because we were invoiced for that amount. Any questions on workers' comp? Unemployment reserves.
Sorry?
In 2017, it was 200. The whole idea behind that is to just make sure we're whole within the consortium because it's us and a bunch of other school districts at the same time. We just want to make sure that we're whole and typically, again, with our workers' compensation consortium, with our health trust consortium, they have minimums that you have to have in your, with the consortium and the health trust itself, and then you typically want to offset that with reserves just in case you have a bad year that you unemployment insurance continues to remain steady. We haven't had or needed to dip into what we've had there, so that remains steady. I think that's a good place for us to be at this point. Any questions on unemployment? Okay, insurance reserve. This is still an outstanding case. There's a deposition meeting that took place on May 3rd. The summary is still pending from the attorneys, but when the question was asked, is this something that's going to be wrapped up in the next few months, the answer is no. Likely a decision will be made within the next year. So another legal thing that was fun to wait for that to finish. Encumbrances, pointed this out last year, pointed out again this year. Encumbrances aren't really something that I feel comfortable reporting on just because if I were to show you the encumbrance number right now, it would be millions and millions and millions of dollars just because it's money that is set aside in the earmark for purchases and items that haven't come in yet. That includes health insurance bills, that includes workers' compensation bills, it basically includes any bill we have yet to pay as we close out the 22-23 school year. So as I did last year, I'm just leaving it at what it was. I'll have that number finalized once the audit is completed after the June 30th close date. Employee ERS, TRS reserve, they were combined a few years ago, no change there. Tax tertiary reserve, I briefly went over earlier. We do have that outstanding check amount for $232,750. Our available balance is actually that $267,000 number. That's just once they cash the check, that's how much money we're going to have left in there.
So again, you're going to put that, you're going to leave that there, or you're going to put that in there?
So what I'm doing right now is I'm compiling a document to the auditors to substantiate a certain amount of money in there. Once I get more information from the IDA so that they can tell me the likelihood of these tax tertiaries going anywhere, the reason I say that, one of the two is actually under a pilot, so it may or may not be affected. I just have to look further into the language because it wasn't produced 2 years ago, I believe it was, and it was a 10-year freeze. So if I can substantiate
stay in there. If I can only substantiate half of it, only half of it will stay in there. And my recommendation at that point will likely be, I don't want to say it will be, but will likely be something to the effect of, let's move it to the capital reserve. This is our OPEB, our employee benefit. This is typically a number that we are able to retrieve once the audit has taken place. No change there this time. And then we've got our newly named 2014 capital reserve. This is the old reserve. We do have a budget line in the annual general fund budget for $50,000 to be transferred into this reserve. You don't see it yet because that transfer doesn't take place until the close of the school year. The reason that's the case is they need to make sure that all programs and everything else can be paid for in full before they can move that $50,000 over. We've never had a problem with that. We do not anticipate a problem with that this year. I do suggest, as you know, Don, you just pointed out there, like if the tax certiorari, I can't substantiate every dollar in there. What I would strongly advise us to do is to put our money into this reserve before putting it into the new one, only because this reserve, we can't add to it beyond May 20th, 2014. So I would like to add to this because the other one, we've got a 10-year span to add to. Okay, and here's our new reserve. What?
You said 2014.
I do that.
Just testing us?
Yeah, just make sure you're paying attention. All right, and then the other thing, and I just noticed, on the bottom of this line right here, that number should be zero for the balance. Copied it over from the last one. There's no balance in there, so I do need to fix that. But like I said before, probable life is 10 years. Maximum amount is $5 million. This is what we just voted on. I had to need a bunch of votes. But again, please ignore all the dollars outside.
There's a lot of money in there.
All right. So these are just some measures we take annually. And some other things really happening when it comes to reserve. Everything is monitored frequently. We look at these with our auditors frequently to make sure that A, we're in compliance with the rules of a reserve, and B, just to make sure that we are setting ourselves up for any surprises that may occur. That's the whole point of a reserve. Any questions for me on that? Any questions overall?